Okay, so in the previous class, you have learnt how to find out how to set the objectives for the compensator to compensate the desired component of the load currents and to get the desired component of currents from the source. In this lecture 35, we will discuss the same concept and simplify the expression for the reference compensator currents. Now you have seen for the A matrix in the previous class, we already have proved that the determinant of the matrix A is given by BSAB square plus BSBC square plus BSC square, which CSA square, so put A here, okay. So this is line to line voltage square. We also have proved that this is also equal to 3 times of sigma BSJ square for JAVC minus 3 BSA0 square, where BSA0 is nothing but 1 by 3 of VSA plus BSB plus BSC. There is one more variation of this, and which is given as following here. The delta A, which is equal to 3 times of sigma BSJ square, which means BSA square plus BSB square plus BSC square, and minus is this term minus 3 BSA0 square, you can put A here. Okay. Now I have used some simply S0 or simply S, so do not get confused. Here I have taken BS0 is equal to BSA0 equal to B0. Okay. So this is same thing, BSA0, this is also BSA0, but we can also use BS0. But remember, A has been dropped, but A is there. Actually, there is a difference between BS0 and BSA0. As per definition of unity transformation, B0 is nothing but 1 by root 3 actually. So the difference is of the magnitude BSB plus BSC, and BSA0 is 1 by 3. But here, for the sake of convenience, we have used the same term. So what we did, the 3 is common, and this is VSA square plus VSB square plus VSC square. This we made in form of 3 VSA0 square minus 6 VSA0 square. So minus 6 plus 3 becomes again minus 3. It is just way of simplifying this expression. You need to correct it here. This is actually into, not here but downwards here, this is bracket close into VSA0, then close the bracket. Okay, now 3 VSA0 is same as BSA plus BSB plus BSC. This is the value of 3 BSA0 from this. Is it clear? So 3 VSA0 is nothing but VSA plus BSB plus BSC. And this is being replaced here. This is into BS0 again, this term, and into 2. Okay? So we multiply these terms with BSA0, we will get terms given here, minus 2 BSB BSA0, this into this, and minus 2 BSA BSA0, this term, minus 2 BSC into BSA0, this term. So we have distributed along with the square term. So this is about first one, second one, and third one. Then we have minus 3 BSA0 square. So this, sorry, plus 3 BSA0 square. So this plus 3 BSA0 square is being distributed here, here, and here. And we already have BSA square plus BSB square plus BSC square, and these have been taken. One is here, second is here, and third is here. Okay, so in this way we have taken all the terms. And now as you can see that these terms make the square of BSA minus BSA0 square. So this term becomes the BSA minus BSA0 square. And the second one is BSB minus BSA0 square. And the third term is BSC minus BSA0 square. So we get these three terms. We can write in the form of the summation series BSJ minus BSA square, where J is equal to ABC, and three times of this. So now we see that the determinant of A matrix. So we see here that the determinant of A matrix can be written in form of three expressions. Number one, line to line voltage square, summation of line to line voltage square. Number two, three times of summation of each phase voltage square minus 3 BSA0 square. And third one is three times of BSJ minus BSA0 square for JABC. These all three expressions are equivalent. They are same. Depending upon the convenience of simplification, we can use any of these expression. So this is about the determinant of matrix A. We were also looking for cofactors, because we have proved earlier that to find the current IFA star, we have to find ILA minus ISA star. And ISA star we proved is equal to AC31 into PL average by delta A. So we have to prove that this is equal to this as a final expression. Therefore, we have found the value of this one. We can find the value of PL average. We have to find the cofactors AC31, AC32, and AC33. Now, as you can see, the matrix A is here. Okay, so you can see this is the matrix A which we have formulated in the previous class. And when I say cofactors AC31, AC32, and AC33, basically I mean the cofactor of third row, first column. So cofactor of this, then cofactor of this, and then cofactor of this. Okay, so this big element becomes AC33. This is AC32, third row, second column, and this is AC31. This is what we require. So let us find AC31, and then others can be also found. So let us say AC31. So AC31 will be nothing but this row and this column, this row and this column will go away. So this into this minus this into this. Okay, so you can see it here in this expression that AC31 is equal to BSA. So first one is BSA into 1. So this is BSA into 1 whole expression. So BSA minus BSB plus beta BSA plus BSB minus 2 BSA, this term. Okay, this term. this into 1, so 1 has come, minus this into again 1. So now this is BSC here, minus BSC plus B beta into BSC plus BSA minus 2BSB. Now again, same simplification we use, we will collect the coefficients of beta and non-beta terms. So this is beta term here, this is non-beta term here. Okay. So non-beta term has BSA minus BSB, BSA minus BSB here, and minus BSC minus BSA becomes minus BSC plus BSA. Okay. Minus minus become plus here. And beta terms are BSA plus BSB, the first one, BSA plus BSB minus 2BSC, and minus term is here, so minus BSC minus BSA plus 2BSB. And you see that BSA, VSA will go away. And then we will get this term BSB minus BSC. 3 will be common because 2 is here and 1 is here, and 2 is here, 1 is here. So 3 is common here. So 3 beta BSB minus BSC. This is the beta coefficient. And on the left hand side, we collect non-beta coefficient. You can see BSA is here and BSC is here. So this is 2BSA. We will add one more BSA here and subtract one more BSA. Okay? See the trick here in this expression. We will add one BSA and subtract one BSA. So this BSA, this BSA, this BSA become 3BSA. So this is 3BSA. The remaining is minus BSB, minus BSC, minus BSA. So this is minus BSA and minus BSB, minus BSC. Minus is common, so all become positive inside. Okay. Now this is nothing but 3 times of BSA 0, as we have discussed earlier. So this becomes 3 times of BSA 0. Therefore 3BSA minus 3BSA 0 plus 3 beta BSB minus BSC. Okay, etc. Then take 3 common in all, and we will get this term as beta into BSA minus BSA 0 plus beta 3 into BSA minus BSA 0 plus beta BSB minus BSC. This factor is AC 3-1, cofactor 3-1. And similarly, you can prove, try yourself. I'm not going to repeat this, but it is very simple. Okay, just collect the coefficient of beta and non-beta terms and simplify them. You will get AC 3-2 as 3 times of BSB minus BSC plus beta BSC minus BSA. So what we did, we simply update the subscript. C becomes A, B becomes C, and A becomes B. Okay. Therefore, AC 3-1 is 3 times of this term. And then AC 3-3, similar to this, you can prove that AC 3-1 is equal to 3 times of BSC minus BSA 0 plus beta BSA minus BSB. Again, update the subscript to next one. So these are the cofactors that we require for the simplification of the compensated source current or filter current. Now we will use the expression for ISA. So as we have done earlier, that IFA star is nothing but ILA minus ISA star, Kirchhoff current law at the point of common coupling. Okay. And now we have proved that ISA is nothing but, or ISA star is nothing but AC31 by delta A into PL average. We know what is AC31. It is 3 times of BSA minus BSA0 plus beta BSB minus BSC. And determinant is 3 times of sigma BSJ square minus 3 BSA0 square. Okay, so this is the determinant. This 3 will go away with this 3. And we have only the term here. Okay, this is the term ISA. So ISA is nothing but this term BSA minus BSA0 plus beta into BSB minus BSC. This is BSB minus BSC. And in the denominator we have sigma BSJ square minus 3 BSA0 square for J equal to ABC into PL average, average load power. Okay, this is the term for ISA. If you want to say it is reference current, because it is by computation, you can say ISA star, the ideal source current. Then we have ISB. Similar expression, except that we update the subscript to next one. A becomes B, B becomes C. So this is the ISB star equal to BSB minus BSA0 plus B beta BSC minus BSA in bracket divided by sigma BSA square minus 3 BSA0 square into PL average. And similarly, we have the ISC, which is equal to BSC minus BSA0 plus beta BSA minus BSB divided by sigma BS0 square minus BSA0 square into PL average. Okay, so these are 3 equations and from which we can find out the reference compensator currents. Now, since we know we have solved for ISA, desired ISA, ISB, ISC, we can find out now the reference compensator current, because we know that IFA is nothing but IFA star is nothing but ILA minus ISA. So we know that IFA star is nothing but ILA minus ISA star. And we substitute ISA star here. This is ISA star. Then we will get the expression for this term. I can slightly reduce it here. Okay, so this is IFA, this is A phase current, and I do not know, there is always some problem with this software. Okay, this is ISA, IFA, IFB, IFC, and the value is ILA minus ISA. The whole thing is ISA star. Okay, so this is ISA star, this is ISB star, ISB star, and the third one is ISC star, this is ISC star. Okay, so these are the expressions for reference filter currents in terms of the load parameters, which are simply load currents and voltages at the point of common coupling and the computation of average load power. Therefore, the reference current extraction depends upon the measurement of the load parameters, the load currents. Okay, so we have to measure the load currents ILA, ILB, ILC. We can use the current transducers or we can use the Hall effect current transducers, and we have to measure the voltages VSA, VSB, VSC at the point of common coupling, and then compute BSA0 and the denominator itself, and then beta is nothing but define power factor from the source. So beta is tan phi plus y root 3. Suppose you miss unity power factor, then phi is 0, then beta is 0. If you missed this phi plus as 0.8 lag, then phi plus becomes cos inverse 0.8 minus of that, because lagging phase angle. So beta depends upon the desired power factor from the source. Clear? So we need to compute this. Then PL average. PL average has to be computed by the measurement of the load power at the point of at the load point. Okay. So actually, what is PL? The PL is nothing but BSA into ILA plus BSB into ILB plus BSC into ILC. Again, we can take the average value of this by using moving average filter. I described this moving average filter in PQ theory. Same concept is used like this. And we can use the limits, in fact, T1 minus T here. So this becomes T1 minus T to T1, one cycle data. And this can be equal to the series of mean function, actually, mean of closed bracket. So this is the running average of the, for I is greater than 720. Okay, so this becomes PL average. We can substitute back here. So what do we need to compute the reference filter current? Number one, the load currents. Number two, the PCC voltages. And number three, the PL average. And then some computations, BSA 0 and sigma BSA 0 square and so on and so on. Okay. Why this is called instantaneous symmetrical component? Because we use the concept of instantaneous symmetrical component, and also the change in IFA, IFB, IFC is instantaneous. In the sense that all quantities are instantaneous, even PL average, because it's a running average. So any new data affects the PL average computation. But the settling time of this compensator will be one cycle, because it involves the data over one cycle, mean over one cycle. So settling of one cycle, settling of the PL average will be done after one cycle. And hence, the settling time for this compensator is one cycle. All right. Let us simplify these expressions a little bit so that we can understand what is going on. Okay. If you look this expression, this one, this side, we can simplify number by saying that the source voltages or PCC voltages are balanced. That means that BSA0 will be 0. Okay. BSA0 will be 0, because it is summation of three voltages like BSA plus BSB plus BSC by 3. Since they are balanced and sinusoidal with a fundamental frequency, so the sum is equal to 0. Let us also desire that the power factor at the source is unity. Therefore, phi plus is equal to 0. And therefore, beta is also equal to 0. Because beta is tan phi plus y root 3. So substitute beta 0 here, substitute BSA 0 here, we will get this term. IFA star equal to ILA minus BSA by sigma BS j square into PL average. Okay. Then IFB star equal to ILB minus BSBY sigma BSJ square into PL average. And IFC star is equal to ILC minus BSCY sigma BSJ square into PL average. Because BS A0 is gone, beta term is gone. Now, do these expressions make sense? So let us further focus on the denominator term, this term. The denominator term is sigma BSJ square. Okay, if we take, we already have taken balance voltages, so BS equal to root 2B sin omega t, BSB is root 2B sin omega t minus 120 degree, and BSC is root 2B sin omega t plus 120 degree. If we square and sum them, that is BSA square plus BSB square plus BSC square, then you can see this is root 2B sin omega t square, this is root 2B sin omega t minus 120 square, and this is root 2B sin omega t plus 120 square. So B square is common, this becomes 2 sin square omega t. Okay, this becomes 2 sin square omega t, which is 1 minus cos omega t, and this becomes 2 sin square 2 omega t minus 120 degree, square omega t minus 120 degree, this becomes cos 2 omega t minus 120 degree, and this becomes 2 sin square omega t plus 120 degree simplified to cos 2 omega t plus 120 degree. 1 minus cos, okay? So square sin square theta becomes 1 minus cos 2 theta. So each is 1 minus cos, 1 minus cos, 1 minus cos. So 1 plus 1 plus 1 become 3. So this becomes 3b square. And then minus b square cos 2 omega t plus cos 2 omega t minus 120 plus cos 2 omega t plus 120 degree. This is a balanced sinusoid. If you sum them, the sum will be equal to 0. And hence, the value of sigma Vs0 square Bsj square for J ABC equal to 3B square, which is a constant value, 3 times of RMS voltage square. Okay? RMS voltage square. So, per phase RMS voltage square is B square. As if the each phase contributes the value V square. That is true. You can see it here that this is V square, this is V square, this is V square. Okay. Each terms contribute to V square, and the next term is the cosine term, which finally add up to zero. All right. So therefore, we substitute now this as 3b square. It looks like that small bsj square will be a time-varying function, but it is not time-varying function, it is a constant quantity, and the value is 3b square. So 3b square will come here, this is bsa into PL average. Now this can be thought as PL average by 3, per phase real power sharing by the source divided by B square, which we can write B square by denominator B square by PL average by 3. Okay, so this becomes B square, look here, B square divided by PL average by 3. You can say that PL average by 3 is the power shared by each phase of the source supply. So as if PSA is equal to PL average by 3 equal to PSB equal to PSC. Because this is the total real power. And if the source would like to behave as a balanced source, then it has to share the one-third power. Each phase has to share one-third power. So I can think of PS, PL average by 3 is a one term, and B square. Now, what is the dimension of this term? PL average by 3, or you can say V square by PSA. The dimension is impedance, you can say, okay, or you can say resistance. So we can write this ILA minus BSA, this is BSA, divided by equivalent resistance, resistance equivalent. Of course, the whole thing is nothing but ISA star. So what do you see? ISA star is equal to VSA by R equivalent. And therefore, IS star is in phase with BSA. And C is an equivalent resistance of R equivalent. Each phase sees the equivalent resistance R. So if you look from the source side, then ZSA equal to ZSB equal to ZSC equal to R equivalent. As if the supply is like this. Okay, A phase, this is B phase, this is C phase. So each phase sees the resistance, same resistance in all three phases, and therefore the source is supplying the basically balance load. Okay, same is true for IFB and IFC star. There is no difference, and we have proved that yes, we are getting the ISA star, which is in phase with the voltages. So I hope the concept is clear. We will take one example and then complete this part. Okay, this example is 5.5 from our book, Power Quality and Distribution System, and NPTEL book, which I have given to you as I upload in the Moodle. And this example says that if we have three phase voltages, okay, that is BSA and BSB, BSC, as balance source with the RMS value of 230 and phase angle displacement of minus 120 and plus 120 degree. The load impedances are 5 plus J12 and 3 plus J12, J4, and 5 minus J12. This is capacitive load, this is inductive load, this is inductive load. Then, using instantaneous reactive power theory, we need to compute, number one, the reference filter current. So make it a star, IFA star, IB star, because they are reference currents. And also compute the equivalent ZFA, ZFB, ZFC, ZFB and ZFC. We want to feel in terms of the passive component, then what will be the value of the impedance for this compensator. Also find the source current after compensation and check whether you get PS equal to PL and QS equal to 0 and PF equal to 0 and QF equal to QL. Okay, a very simple example which verifies the concept in finer details. Now, since it is three phase four wire system, so we can directly find the current ILA, ILB, ILC by solving BSA by ZLA and so on. So this is BSA and this is ZLA. So this is the RMS value of the A phase load current and this is the phase angle. Similarly, we have B phase and phase angle, and C phase RMS value and phase angle. So you can see they are quite unbalanced. This is 17.69, this is 46, and this is 17.69. Then we find sigma BSA square or BSJ square, which is sum of BSA square plus BSB square plus BSC square. Okay, so this is BSA square, BSB square, BSC square, which is equal to 3 into B square, 3 into RMS voltage square. So 3 into 230 square becomes 158,700 volt square. Okay. Then we compute the PL average. The PL average is nothing but real of BSA into ILA conjugate plus BSB into ILB conjugate plus BSC into ILC conjugate. This makes 99,478.2 watts. So this is the average load power. Remember, this is the PL average, or simply PL bar. This power has to come from the source. Therefore, this has to be equal to PS. So PS has to be equal to PL average equal to PL bar. So we know PL average, we know BSA and sigma BSJ square, we can find out the value of reference filter current. Since this question does not involve the harmonics, because we have fundamental unbalanced load, we can compute on the phasor basis. Otherwise, it's difficult to compute. You have to go for computer for simulation. So only this problem can be solved analytically, because there is only one frequency, that is fundamental frequency. So equation that IFA star equal to ILA minus BSA into PL average by sigma BSJ square becomes IFA star in phasor domain, because only one frequency is there, ILA minus BSA into PL average by 3B square. Okay, this is all on phasor basis. So because of one frequency involvement, we can use phasor here. So IFA equal to ILA minus BSA into PL average by sigma BSA square here. Similarly for IFB and IFC. Substitute these values. This is 3B square, this is PL average, this is BSA, and this is ILA. Simplify them, you will see that the value of IFA is 17.74 angle of minus 113 degree. And IFB is 39.32 angle of 170. IFC is 17.74 angle of minus 127. It is by chance that they are just same magnitude in phase A and phase C. It need not to be. Okay, so it need not to be, it is just by chance it is happening here. And therefore we can construct the time domain expressions for the filter current. IFA star, you can say it's a star because it's estimated value, correct, is 17.74 into root 2 peak value into sine omega t minus angle of that. And this is 39.32 into root 2 angle of 170 degree. 17.74 angle of minus 127. So these are reference filter currents that the compensator has to be generated. It has to generate these compensator currents with the help of the inverter. Now let us find out the real and imaginary or reactive powers of the load and source, and verify whether they are okay or not. So if you find out the PF, so PF is nothing but real of BSA into IFA conjugate. This is basically nothing but SFA plus SFB, the apparent power, complex apparent power, and SFC. So we know IFA, IFB, IFC, we know IBSA, BSB, BSC, we can find out the each phase power. Alright? So what do you expect? The reference compensator real power must be equal to 0. and it is 0. And QF equal to the imaginary of the each phase apparent power, and its value is equal to 8464 volt ampere reactives. And it must be equal to QL. That's how it works. The all load reactive power must be equal to the compensator reactive power. Only the real power has to come from the supply. That is the fundamental thing of the compensation. Now let us find out, you may ask question that overall real power is 0, I understand. What about the individual phase real power of the compensator? So let us find out PFA. So what is PFA? Real of BSA into IFA conjugate. This is PFA. So PFA is -1594, PFB is 3188.6 and PFC is -1494.3. And if we sum these three powers, then you see the overall real power of the compensator equal to 0. Okay, but the individual real powers have some values, they are not 0. They have some values such that the sum is equal to 0. It means that each phase of the compensator handles some kind of a real power. You can see this is negative real power. This is positive real power. This is negative real power. So negative real power means that phase is generating the real power and circulating among other phases. And positive means it is consuming. So this phase is consuming. These two phases are generating, such that the generation plus consumption, the whole power is equal to 0. That is the beauty of active power filter. This possibility doesn't exist for the passive filters. That's why we migrated from the passive filters to the active filters. Okay, we felt the need for using active power filter which can handle the current in such a way that even it can generate, but it is local generation and local consumption without affecting any real power flow between the source and the compensator. Similarly, QFB is 3756.2, QFB is 8464 and QFC is -3756.2. These cancels, by chance they are cancelling here, need not to cancel, but here they are cancelling. So the overall value of QF is equal to QFA plus QFB plus QFC 8464 mega. And this is same as the load real reactive power. So this is QL as well, which is correct. Now if we compute the ZFA and ZFB and ZFC, then you can say that ZFA must be equal to BSA by minus IFA. Minus IFA because we have taken sign opposite of the current. Okay, we have taken sign like this, and this is PCC, this is ground. So actually current should be like this, but I have taken like this IFA star, and therefore minus sign will come in the computation of this impedance. So this is minus sign, and with this the current is -5.06 minus J imaginary part of 11.93. similarly ZFB is -2.06 minus J5.47, and ZFC is 5.06 J11.93. You see, these two can be realized because resistance is positive, but this cannot be realized. Even in this case, the resistance is there, therefore we cannot realize the impedance without the real power consumption, because it involves the resistance part here. Although the net active power is 0, but it cannot be managed with the passive filters. and hence we use active filters. Alright, then we find the value of source current, which is very simple. Source current is ILA minus IFA. Okay, if you want, you can term use star. It's not, it's already understood is a star, of course, because this is a theoretical computation. This is computation on the paper, not by the real inverter. And the value is 13.74 angle 0, 13.74 angle of minus 120, 13.74 angle of 120 degree. That means they are perfectly balanced and sinusoidal. And in phase with their respective voltage. Phase voltages. And this was the target of compensation. In time domain, we can express 13.74 into root 2 becomes ISM, source side maximum value into sin omega t minus 120 and sin omega t plus 120 degree. Okay, so we see that after compensation, we get the source current which are perfectly sinusoidal and they are in phase with their respective voltages. So we see irrespective of the unbalance on the three phase load side, we have compensated successfully to achieve the balance and sinusoidal currents on the supply side. Let us find out the powers. So as you can see, the PS is equal to real of VSA into ISA conjugate, this term here. Now this is equal to 9478.2, this is same as PL. So therefore, PS is equal to PL bar or PL average. And QS, the source reactive power equal to 0. Okay, so we find that after compensation, PS is equal to capital PS is equal to PL bar and QS equal to 0 and PF equal to 0 and QF is equal to QL. Alright, there are many examples, many questions at the end of the chapter. Please solve them, verify your answers. In the next class, one more article of this unit exists, that is the compensating delta connected load. How do we compensate when the load is delta connected? I will discuss about in the next class.